Hello there, this is Rupesh and you are watching CPPNet's video series on C++, and in this video we'll see how to pass any value in your program using reference here. Okay, so let's look at the code here. This is your function and let's suppose this is your main function. You are creating this variable val and we are printing the value of that val, and after that we are passing that into this function and we are taking it as reference here. So this is what we are going to learn today. Okay, so what is the significance of taking it as a reference? Before in this video we were not taking this as reference here, so in this video we'll see how to take it as reference and what is the significance of taking it as reference here. Okay, and what do I mean by taking it reference here? Okay, so we'll compile it line by line. Like first we'll come to this line, then we'll come to this line and we'll create a variable value 10 in that. We'll come here and we'll print the value. So 10 will be printed. We'll come here and we'll see that okay, update function is there. We'll call this with the value variable. We'll go here and integer reference. So how this will get in your memory, we'll see that. So what we are doing here is we are taking this val as reference. Okay, so there is this 10 somewhere in your memory like this, and this val is pointing to that memory. Okay, and the value at that memory is 10. Okay, so by taking this as reference here, you are telling that I'm going to create another variable called x, and this x is also pointing to the same memory location, and that memory location is holding 10 as value. Okay, so if you will change x here like x plus 10 and initialize that value into the x, which is making this x as 20. So what you are doing, you are changing this x, means you are changing this only. Okay, so you are removing this 10 from here and you are putting 20 here. So after doing this, you will come to this and this is the end of the function. You will come back and now you are printing value after change. So here the same variable, this val, will print 20. Okay, so here it was printing 10 because it was holding 10. After updating this variable, it is printing 20. Okay, because indirectly it was changed by x, which is pointing to the same memory location what this value is pointing. Okay, so this is how this passing by reference work. Okay, so let's check that. If we will run this, it will give you the output here. See, value before changing was 10, after changing it is 20. Okay, and both the time we are printing this val only. Got it? Let's suppose you are not passing this reference here, then what would be the scenario? Run this. See, even if you are changing here, this change is not coming to this val. See, both the time it is 10 only. So let's try to understand this case now. So forget about this one now and forget about this reference also. Okay, there is no reference here. So in that case, if you will pass this as you are passing it without reference, only 10 will come here and there is this another memory location get created and 10 will be assigned to that and x will point to that memory location. Before, x was pointing to the same memory location what val is pointing, but now this time val will be like this, 10 val, it is pointing here and another memory location will get created and x will point to that memory location. So as you can see, both are pointing to the different memory location. So in that case, if you will change x here, so x will be changed and 20 will be changed here where this x is pointing. So it won't affect this val. That's why this time we are getting here only 10. Okay, it is not being affected here. So this is the difference between calling by reference and calling by value. Okay, so let's look at the next video which talks about how to call by pointers. So this was about calling by reference here like this, and now in next video we'll be talking about how to call by pointers. Okay, so let's look at the next video now.